Hello friends, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin this video. But before that, let me tell you that the questions that I'm going to discuss in this video can be of use for your upcoming RBI SEBI NABARD examination in the phase 1. And if you're appearing for any kind of banking examination at the level of PO, then also these questions can be of relevance for you. So do listen to me till the end of this video. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you are a newcomer here, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can directly connect with the mentors here, and you can also enjoy the free quizzes that we provide on this group. This is the new course for 2022, so let me tell you details about this course. So we have PDFs, videos and mocks in this course. Apart from this, we also provide interview assistance. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your interviews as well. Apart from this, we also send the book kit at your place if you enroll in this course, and that book kit will contain all the books mentioned on the screen right now. Right now, we are running a 30% discount on this course, and you can use that discount, you can avail that discount by using the RBI30 coupon code. But still, if you have any query related to the course, syllabus or anything else, you can just call us on the number mentioned on your screen right now. Okay, so that was all about the introduction. Now let's begin the current affairs with this first question. What is the name of the helpline launched by National Commission for Protection of Child Rights to provide psychological first aid and emotional support to children affected during COVID-19 pandemic? Samvedana, Drishti, Sanyam, Jyoti, Pragati are the five options. Out of these, the right answer is option A, Samvedana. Now guys, this is basically a toll-free helpline that will provide consultation to the children, particularly children who fulfill three conditions. What are these three conditions? First, that the children might be in quarantine or he must be affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Secondly, the children who have lost their parents due to the COVID pandemic. Or third, the children whose parents or whose family members are currently affected by the COVID-19 disease. So all these children will be eligible to avail guidance through this Samvedana toll-free number. Now guys, that was the eligibility for children. You should also be aware of the fact that National Commission for Protection of Child Rights comes under the Ministry of Women and Child. So we have discussed all the facts relevant for this news. Now I would like to ask a question from you, and my question is that you have to mention the Ministry of Women and Child Affairs. So Ministry of Women and Child Development. So now guys, those were the facts related to this news, but now my question from you is that you have to mention me, the Minister of Women and Child Development, in the comment section below. Now you should also know this fact that Samvedana has a full form. And what is the full form of Samvedana? The full form is Sensitizing Action on Mental Health Vulnerability Through Emotional Development and Necessary Acceptance. So this is basically the full form of Samvedana. So I have put it in blocks so that it will help you to remember it better, because the full form is a little bit lengthy, but I hope that you can now memorize it through these blocks. So Sensitizing Action on Mental Health Vulnerability Through Emotional Development and Necessary Acceptance. So this is the full form of Samvedana. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following university collaborated with Department of Science and Technology for conducting the 7th meet of BRICS Astronomy Working Group? So you have Indian Institute of Science, Indian Institute of Astrophysics, Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, National Center for Radio Astrophysics, Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology. Out of these five options, the right answer is option C, Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, which is located in Pune. Is the right answer. So it has collaborated with DST to have this 7th meet of BRICS Astronomy Working Group. Now guys, you should also be aware of this fact that this year is the 13th edition of BRICS Summit, and the chairmanship of BRICS is with India. So India is holding the chairmanship of BRICS this year in 2021, and India is going to be the president of the 13th summit as well of BRICS. Now your task is to find out the theme of 13th Summit of BRICS, because this is something that I have been telling you repeatedly through the documents, also through the videos as well. So now it is your task to find out the 13th BRICS Summit's theme, that is one most important question that can come in your upcoming examination. Now, as far as the 7th meet of Blake's Astronomy Working Group is concerned, so let me tell you that nothing much happened during that meet. It was just the general discussions that took place during that meeting, and those discussions are not at all important for us from the phase 1 exam point of view. Therefore, we are not going to discuss that. We are moving on to our next question, which is going to be a very, very important question, guys. So do listen to me very carefully. As per the Indian Insurance Company's Foreign Investment Rule 2021, the foreign direct investment limit in the insurance sector has been increased from dash to dash. So here, two limits have been asked from you. The latest one, the amended one, and the recent one, the earlier one, basically the latest one that has been replaced. Now, which were the two limits? Which is the right option here? We have 49% to 74% and so on. The list goes on. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option A, 49% to 74%. So 74% is the latest limit that you should remember, apart from remembering the earlier 49% FDI limit in the insurance sector. Now remember this thing, that the Indian Insurance Company's Foreign Investment Rules 2021. So this is basically an amendment to the rules that came out in 2015. So in 2015, the rules were Indian Insurance Company's Foreign Investment Rules 2015, and now these rules have been amended in order to enhance the FDI limit in the insurance sector. My question from you is that you have to tell me what is the FDI limit in DTH sector, direct to home sector, because that was one question I taught you and an important recent question as well. So tell me in the comment section the FDI limit in DTH sector. Moving on to the next question, which company has launched School of Hope and Empowerment, SHE, as its CSR project at the 2021 UNESCO World Conference on Education for Sustainable Development? So we have Larsen & Toubro, Alphabet Inc., JSW Limited, Tata Communications and IBM. So out of these five options, the right answer is option D. Tata Communications has launched this School of Hope and Empowerment. Now this entire project is summarized or acronymed as SHE. So here you can remember that this project particularly caters to the need of women. Now what kind of need? So this SHE project is going to help the millions of women in the rural areas in India to fulfill their dream of becoming entrepreneurs. So basically this is to make women, or this is basically to motivate women to become entrepreneurs, to become self-dependent, because School of Hope and Empowerment. So from these two words, you can remember the purpose of this entire project. And remember, it is the CSR project of Tata Communications. So I hope that this is clear to you guys. Now let's move further towards this UNESCO World Conference on Education for Sustainable Development. So remember that during that conference, UNESCO has announced to make environmental education an important component of the education across all the countries, across all the member countries. So basically, UNESCO has announced to have environmental education as a necessary part of the education system in schools. So that is one major important announcement that was made by UNESCO during that conference, which is very important for you to remember. So I hope that you have understood the entire question, the project well. My question from you is that you have to tell me the headquarters of UNESCO, and this is a very basic question. I hope that majority of you would remember the answer of this question and would not have to Google it. So do tell me in the comment section below what is the headquarters of UNESCO. Okay. Next is, which has become the first small finance bank to offer online opening services to NRI customers? So we have which one? Janalakshmi, AU, Equitas, Utkarsh. Out of these options, the right answer is Equitas. Equitas Small Finance Bank has become the first small finance bank to offer online account opening services to its NRI customers. So I hope that you have understood this question well, because there is nothing much that we can discuss here. It is just a very basic news that one small finance bank has become the first ever small finance bank in India to offer online account opening services to NRI customers. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video and learned something, and if you have, then do not forget to share this video and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.